What's up, Mercs? It's John here with some more Skyrim, and last time we found the ruins of Weismanstead, and today we're going inside. So before we actually do that, I want to say a few things. One thing is, I did raise the volume for the game, because a few of you were complaining that you couldn't hear the voices of some of the dialogue. I raised volume because voices was already maxed out. I raised the master, and I will try to raise it a little bit more in editing also, so you guys can hear voices a little bit better. Just let me know how that is in the comments. It might take a few episodes to get perfectly right, but just let me know. Also, you guys might be wondering why Dark Souls was in an area that Skyrim was supposed to be. Well, the night I recorded Dark Souls, I thought, you know, I gotta record Dark Souls tonight. What am I doing? And turns out I had to record Skyrim. I was kind of tired that night, and I completely forgot about recording Skyrim. I recorded Dark Souls instead because I thought that's what was the next thing, when it wasn't. But that's unfortunate. There's nothing we can do about that now. We can't do about that. There's nothing we can do about that now. So let's just start here. We lost 2 days, but technically we didn't lose anything because there's no time limit. So let's continue on inside of Weismanstead. I think I'm pronouncing that right. Probably slightly wrong. So let's see. Dwarves. Nothing useful. Dresser. Here we go. No, nothing really useful. See, I'm really low on weight right now. I don't want to take too much. That stuff's not really heavy, so I'll grab that. Did I just see, like, Halls of the Dead? I thought I saw something that said Halls of the Dead. I must be seeing things, because I could have sworn I saw something that said Halls of the Dead, but I'm not sure. Septums, always good. Let's record in the journal, just in case something comes out and brutally murders us, which, from the sound of what happened to the old archivists, I guess that's what you would call them, or scribes, or whatever, that used to be here, that is a very big possibility. Hello? Hello? Oh god, okay. Alright, you know what, let's do it. Holy shit, did a lot of damage. But so does my cool crescent moon thing that I can't remember the name of. But it's badass! There we go. The, what is it called? Azura's Moon. There we go. I knew it was something with the moon. That's all I remembered. It's quite dark in here. I don't know how the scribes even wrote shit down. It's really dark in here. They must have had torches going all over the place. Not anymore, though. Granted, this place has been abandoned for quite a long time. I'm not surprised that a lot of the torches went out. What if I two-handed? That's always not good at all for us, but hey, we can sell it. Wait, can this be opened? Looks like it. It is. Whoa! Whoa! Holy shit! Oh no! Did I get lucky there? He pushed me through the trap. Did I get lucky there? Oh my god. What was that? A Dwemer Spectre Tunnel Architect. What? Daedric Arrows? Pretty good. Grand Soul Gem. A Dynamo Core. Those are pretty expensive, but 4 pounds is kind of a lot. I don't think traps activate a second time. I meant to jump there, but I started sprinting instead. There we go. Dwarven Broadsword of Reaping. Wow. I just like the way Dwarven Broadswords look. But no. Gold Ring. No. Except on the Scroll of Hysteria. Another chest. Oh. Almost. There you go. Amulet of Zenithar. Price is 10% better. And a gold diamond necklace. Always good to sell those kind of things. Although I could wear the Amulet of Zenithar and sell, that would be a good thing. With some increased prices. 10%'s not that much, but altogether, like when it all adds up at the end, that's a fair amount of gold. Too bad, you know, most of the vendors don't even have enough gold for what I have currently, but still. Holy shit! Okay, well, let's wait to go through there. I knew it was a trap, I just couldn't tell what kind. It looked like arrows at first, but nope. Oh, hello. Ow. Electricity hurts. A bunch of dwarven books that I could read and get some lore on the dwarves, but to be perfectly honest, I'm a Khajiit. Do you think I give a shit about reading books about dwarves? No. The only thing I care about is, I don't know, hopefully getting a reward for helping out Falskar. And getting back to Skyrim, and then getting out of Skyrim and going to Solstheim, because I really am curious why those damn cultists kept attacking me. Good thing they didn't follow me to Falskar. They must not know how to get to Falskar, which I guess would make sense. They're not the Traveler, they can't go through the Dwemer Pirtle. Dwemer Pirtle, yes. Okay, let's see. No enemies for a good amount of time. Oh, there's one. A Dwemer Spectre. Holy awesome! This guy looks cool. He's not very strong. But he is badass. I gotta give him that. We got our dresser, which contains nothing really of worth. This Dwarven Oil. How good is it? Like, what does it do exactly? Weakness to magic? That one honestly wouldn't be too good for me. I still gotta enchant this moon, but then again, we didn't even leave this area since I got it. Ooh. This place looks dangerous. Those are traps. Doesn't look like it, actually. Alright, guys, be careful. Watch your backs. Any chests in here? Gold would be nice. Nope. Oh. Oh. Nope. Nothing. Alright, guys, be careful. Looks like this is where the scribes kept, like, is this a library? No. Well, I mean, yeah, there are books around, but maybe it used to be a library and it kind of just destroyed my everything. It just, you know what, I think this was their library, like a makeshift library they had here. So does that mean the book's in here? No, the book is over there. Let's go up and check what's over here. Dwarven solid metal. That's really heavy. Harvesting frostbite spider venom. What? I don't know how to catch them. Where to find them, of course. The larger the hole, the larger the spider. Okay, they're talking about spider. Okay. Basically just how to kill frostbite spiders. What's their weakness too? I think it said ice magic. I have a weapon that can just rip them to pieces. I don't need weaknesses. No! 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 Holy crap! Bob! Oh god, I almost killed him. Bob, you gotta be careful. Dude, you have got to please be careful. Chest. Steel bars. Useless. Useless, I say. We're going to need some more followers, though, to be perfectly honest. Definitely you're going to need more followers. This is completely random, but we need more followers just to interchange some of these. Not that I don't like them, it's just I have tons of names to give to replace slave names, like 25 names, and it's growing like every day, so we're really going to need some more. Die. Almost out of health potions. That was a lot of damage. Ow. What was that that hit me so hard? I mean, I saw the little spider, but was that it? I mean, granted, the spiders do pack a punch, but... Ow! It is! It's laying me on fire! No! Bob! Get him! Get him! Get him! Get him! Get him! Kill him! You guys gotta protect Bob. He doesn't have the same alchemy potion that you guys took. These cool things can kill him. Is there anything... You know what? I couldn't understand. I'm not listening. That fire's still burning. There's nothing over here. I mean, whatever this thing is, it doesn't look like I can turn anything or push any buttons. Bent scrap metal. Be cool if there's like a chest up there. This looks like something, but I guess not. Alright, let's get out of here, guys. Let's go find that book. Okay. Let's go ahead and record the journal, because that was kind of hectic, and I don't want to relive it. Here. I think this is the way we have to go. Oh, we got enemies. Oh, and another thing. That reminds me. Someone said that the game looked way too easy. So we're going to make it expert difficulty. Yay, I'm going to experiment. If it gets ridiculous, as you saw, that one Dwemer killed me instantly. If it gets ridiculous, then I'm just going to turn it down. But hey, expert, there you go. Now it's not too easy. Even though I didn't think it was easy to begin with. What is that? A dwarven automaton guardian? It's like floating. It looks more magical. I guess maybe. Guys, there's a lot of enemies here. You have to be real careful. Look at my Azura's moon. Bob, be careful. What is... Bob! What the... Fucking hell. I gotta kill some of these things. I got one. I gotta get a move on. Bob, stay away. There you go. Stay away from the big thing. Dwarven Centurion Master. And there's a Dwarven Spear, whatever that was, causing issue. The Master's almost dead. Keep hitting him. There we go. The Automaton Guardian's next. He's down. Is everyone okay and alive? Bob's alive. That's everyone. Okay, so... Increasing difficulty. I definitely noticed a difference because they're taking way more damage, or less damage, from me. So yes, I'll keep it like this. If it gets stupidly hard, I'll decrease it, like, to the point where I'm just sitting there dying every time, but I doubt it'll get that bad. And if it's still too easy, let me know in the comments, of course. I will up it more to Master. So, just keep letting me know in the comments. I do take everyone's requests. Seriously, I read all the comments. And also, if you are added to the name list and your name doesn't show up for a while, don't worry. I add every name that I see. If your name doesn't show up for a while, it just means that, well, you weren't randomly picked. I try not to, if your name's been picked once for a role, I try not to pick you again to give, you know, other people a chance. So if your name comes up, I usually redo it. Because, you know, everyone gets a chance. I can't have everyone naming, like, the same character. That'd be kind of ridiculous. Spell Tome, Relentless Spirit. So this looks like two teleporters. What's in here? Oh, yeah. It looks like two teleporters, the ones I came through. So this is interesting. I don't know what this big thing in here is, but those two look like teleporters. Is the book in here? Yeah, it is. Here it is. It's back behind this wall. Let's take it. There we go. Alright, we have the book on the heart chamber, guys. Let's get a move on. I guess we can leave through here. Let me just record the journal that we got the heart chamber book. And let's go on and get out. Elevator. Was that my reward, that chest? That is probably what my reward was. Because normally they have, like, big loot stashes back here. I think that was it. Yeah. Where is that Dwemer spear? Dwarven spear I saw. I didn't search this. What am I doing? Just making sure there aren't any other chests. I already missed one there and got it. Okay. No, it doesn't look like anything. Let me eat something real quick. Do I have any food? I'm out of food. Okay. Let's get out of here, guys. We gotta get back to town. I need to buy a lot of food. Yeah, you guys catch up. Bye! Okay. So wait, this is taking me to Amberhold? Where is it going to put me on the surface? Ah, and a locked door. Oh, wasn't it right here? Oh yeah, I already had this place. Okay. I was already actually here. I remember now it was locked from the outside, from the inside, I mean. Or was I here? Yeah, I think I was. think I was in here before. I don't know. I don't know why I took that merchant hat, but sure. Wait. Clam meat, salmon meat. I need to cook it. We don't have any fires, though. We're probably better off just getting to town. We should be able to get to town before I starve to death. We're not too hungry. Food in here, I wonder. Stale cabbage. More stale cabbage. Yeah. People who lived here a long time ago, so I doubt anything they had is still going to be fresh. Although that salmon meat's still good. Probably. There we go, more sacks over here. Old potato. Soul gem fragment. I don't actually know what soul gem fragments are used for. I would imagine to make soul gems, but never actually done it before. Can't light that campfire. I don't think I have the wood. Here, potatoes. These are actually good. There we go. And we'll check the barrel. Any food? Carrots. And now I'm overweight. So, take the meat back. We have some carrots to last us. Really? Drop the wine. There we go. Alright, so how far exactly are we? Yeah, I was up here before. Okay. So we're not too far away. We're like a 2-3 minute journey. Let's go ahead and call the horse. Let's call Maddie. Horse call is already on. And do that. And just because I have so many names to replace slave names, I actually might think about retiring Maddie. Not getting rid of Maddie or anything, maybe just putting him at the stable at the house and letting him live there. You know, relax. Because he's had a very long and adventurous life, and you know what? He's tired. He needs to relax. He needs to not go away or get eaten or anything like horrible like that, but he needs some time off. I really think he needs a rest. But unfortunately, we can't do that until we're back in Skyrim. Because Valskar doesn't have a house for me. Well, they do have a house for me, but I don't know if I'm willing to pay, what, 10 grand for a house? Damn, that's more than they paid for my house property. I got it, don't worry, guys. Azura's Moon's on the case. There you go. Stupid frostbite bastard. Oh, I should have taken that amethyst. Whatever. Too late now, I don't feel like turning back. Okay. Let's see. We just have to cross the river. How cold is it out, though? I don't want to cross the river if it's really icy cold. That'll be a problem. Oh. Uh-oh. Oh. That was weird. The world froze for a few minutes. Minutes, seconds. Air's cool. We should be fine. What is going on? Let me just, okay, good. Everything, nothing went into the void. We're good. We are good. Nothing went into the void. Okay, but everything is getting a little bit funky. So I'm just going to quick reload, so I'll be right back. Alright, and I am back. What happened here? Dead bandit. Uh-oh. Were they attacked? Yeah. They had to have been. I mean, why would there be dead bandits? Doesn't look like anyone I know. What's going on here?
My dad says I can...
And I'll kill you if you don't. Where are they?
Okay, okay. They're at Fort Urok. He wanted them taken there, but I don't know why. I swear, I don't know why.
Very well. Svegard.
I'm on it.
You are here at a convenient time. Did you find the book?
What in oblivion happened here?
Ingvar has crossed yet another line. He attacked the town, and while we were out fighting his men, Mord snuck in. They took Hjalma and Vilhard. They took them away from me. We are going to get them back. Please, tell me you found the book.
Of course, right here.
Finally. Good news. Thorlo, he got it. Take a look at the book.
Hmm.
Interesting. Yes.
So?
What does it say?
Good news, everyone!
He's not reading it.
Does it have what we need?
Yes. It lists the location of the heart chamber and much else. This is wonderful!
Great. Then let us not waste any more time. We are going to Fort Yeru to save my wife and child.
Of course, Maya. We are ready.
Shall we meet near the fort to plan the attack?
Yes. That is what we'll do. Will you help us attack Fort Yeruk and save my family?
Of course.
Thank you. You are a virtuous warrior.
Where is this fort anyway? Friend.
Meet us at the base of the cliffs below Fort Yeruk. We are going to break in and get my family back.
Where? Meet the group. Whoa, oh, all the way over here. Oh, wow. That's like right next to Stalgard. Huh. Okay, so let me know how the voices are. I'll just quickly show you. Voices at max. And the master used to be down here. I upped it. I mean, I'll even do it a little bit more. I don't want to do it a little too much with it. Like, I want a whole episode with just one volume setting, or it'll be weird in editing. But yeah, so let me know how that was. This is not, you know, vanilla dialogue, so the audio levels could be a little bit weird. Although Falskar has really amazing everything, pretty much, so the audio level shouldn't be anything different. But yeah, let me know how that was. If it's still a little bit quiet, I'll work on it a little bit more, but just let me know.
Yes?
What do we have for sale?
Just about anything you can forge out of metal.
Nothing I really want. So, I should wear these. The only problem is these give me 15 carrying capacity, which is, like, invaluable compared to armor. So, I'm gonna have to enchant those with something new if I want to use them. That reminds me. I need to get my horse. Where's Matty? Let me just store this on him. The Wabajax. I don't really need it on me. I mean, not at all.
Let me know if you'd like some mead.
It's on the menu.
We have all sorts of food and drink for the
Okay, we need apple cabbage, dog meat, and vegetable soup. And you can't fill water up here. Which is unfortunate, but I guess we'll have to get our water filled back at Skyrim. We have plenty of liquids to hold us over, so it doesn't really matter. Let's go in the general store, or in this case, the general wall. And let's go ahead and see what wares she has, or how much gold she has to spend on me.
What's a handsome man like you doing in them? Books, potions, armor, all sorts of goods.
Nothing too amazing. Take my amulet, so I should be wearing that amulet that increases prices, but eh. Oh, you're out of gold. Already? You're so poor. Here, there's some more gold. Some more that I can take. And she's already out of gold again. Jeez. Everyone's so poor. All the merchants are poor. It's crazy how much money I have. Or how much I, like, can spend. How many things I have is a better thing to say. Okay, Manny. Let me just access your satchel. That have these. I guess it's 40 pounds. That should be fine. All right, Manny, off we go to the east. Let me make sure I record in the journal that we're moving out, just in case we don't want to go through that all again. And it is quite a distance. All I do is follow the river, though. So that's exactly what we'll do. We'll follow the river. Now, I mean literally, we're going to follow that river a little bit more than I should, actually. What is the temperature? Temperate? Even better. Well, I better dress warmly here. What is... There we go. Couldn't remember which one was my warm clothes. So let's dress warm. And then we can go ahead and hitch a ride. Who's this? Not a bandit, right? No. I would take Maddie, but I don't think it's safe. Who is that? Hey! Oh, that's all them. They're still here. You guys are slow. I'm taking the express route, guys. Have a nice trip. Alright, here we go. Down arrow, following the river. Khajiit style. Oh, this is stupid as fuck. Woo! Oh, yeah. Oh, God, I broke my legs. Wow, I'm right at the bottom. That was fast. I broke my legs. It's okay. Magic heals legs. Magic heals bones? Duh. Don't you know? There you go. And let's continue. We can just... If I really wanted to, I could just sleep in this water and... Just, well, I guess, you know. I guess I would eventually drown. But still. I can make myself a makeshift raft and just be on my way. I think I'll run, though. Because Maddie can't go over such obstacles such as rocks and... Through little gaps between the trees and the water. So running is probably the most... the speediest way. Not the most speediest. The speediest. Because most speediest isn't right. The speediest way to get there. Although a carriage would probably have been faster, but there are no carriages in Falskar, unfortunately. Through the bridge. So we should almost be there by now. Yeah, we're like halfway. No thanks. So this is definitely a fast way. All I have to do is follow this river, and then when it comes to the actual end curve, I just have to go across. This is where the Falmer were, I believe. What's going on? Someone's like... I don't know where my companions are. I guess they don't like water. Oh yeah, they don't. Wish I can take that rowboat over there. That probably would be faster, especially on a river like this. I don't even need it, but screw it. I'll take it. I'll take it. I want an urn. Why not? I don't need it, but sure. I'll take it. At this rate, we should almost be by there. We should almost be there. Here we go. We got another water ride. Let's make sure I record in the journal so this doesn't kill me. Oh, yeah. Going rapids. Going on the rapids. We're almost there. Yeah, this is really fast, actually. I don't need to worry about the cold when it's warm out. Wait, who's trying to kill me? Who's trying to kill me? Oh, God, that was scary. I couldn't see anything. The water was swallowing me. Yes. Yeah. Went over there fast. Awesome river. I love rivers. So cool. Okay. I hear fighting. Is that them? Really? They beat me? Impossible. They didn't take the friggin' River Express. What is this? Let's go and assist. I mean, I heard clashing of swords, but maybe not. Huh. Is anybody fighting over here? We have to meet like right here, don't we? Yeah, right here. And no one's here yet. Let's wait an hour. See if they show up. There we go. They're my followers. There you all are. So where's Angar? Or Angar. Agnar.
Meet us all at Fort Yeru.
And
hurry.
Safe travel.
Yeah, we're here.
Watch it.
We're here. What? There we go. Oh, there. We just had to nudge him a little bit. Yeah, open it.
Watch out.
Sorry.
Yeah?
Hold on. I have arrived.
Watch it.
Mind yourself.
Get off. Come on, open it, someone. What is going on here? I guess I'll have to wait another hour since these people don't understand what they're doing. Yes. It's gonna be nighttime. What was that? Are we ready to go in? Well, I think I'm going to end today's journey here, so I will see you all next time. Goodbye.